many times when it's necessary to remove a tooth or teeth, the bone shrinks significantly, leaving an objectionable aesthetic defect. Additionally, accidents or numerous other situations cause bone loss in the mouth. This patient had an upper front tooth extracted and the bone shrunk, leaving a defect that will influence his smiles negatively when a restoration or bridge is placed in that location. This patient had an even worse defect result from a tooth extraction. Can these defects be prevented? Yes, they can. Careful extraction of teeth preserves as much bone as possible, and I'm sure your dentist will try his or her very best to keep as much bone there as possible when taking teeth out. However, some bone shrinkage is unavoidable unless some form of bone graft, we're going to describe to you, is placed in the defect that's left when the teeth are removed. Even with grafting, slight bone shrinkage occurs, but the final result is significantly better than without grafting. Let's look in a little more detail. Do you like that patient's smile? I don't. You see how the gum goes up and down, up and down? This patient has had a tooth removed and a fixed bridge placed connected to the adjacent teeth. Bone shrinkage has made the replacement false tooth appear to be longer, making a non-symmetrical smile. The patient was displeased, as you probably would be. As you might expect, new bone will grow into a fresh wound in your bone spontaneously. But the bone growth is often less than desirable for adequate reconstruction of the site aesthetically or functionally. On the left of this image, you see a graft placed into a bony defect. In this case, it is cow bone that's been medically changed so that your body can accept it for a brief period of time. It is essentially a scaffold or a matrix for new bone growth. The center image shows bone growing into that scaffold. You see the blood vessels there. The right image shows the cow bone is nearly eaten away by cells within your body and new bone is being formed. It's almost totally formed in that image. The most commonly used bone grafts are either human bone or cow bone that is replaced with the patient's own bone over a period of months. Occasionally, artificial bone is placed that stimulates growth in and around the graft. This is not natural bone. It's chemistry that allows bone to grow in and around it. An example of such a graft is shown in the following images. This tooth was removed because of a root fracture, resulting in a bony defect. An artificial polymer or plastic graft was placed in the site of the extraction. On the left, you see the graft at the time of the tooth extraction. On the right, you see the graft at 2 years of maturation with a fixed bridge attached to the remaining teeth. The graft has filled in the bony defect well and allows an aesthetic restoration of the patient's mouth. I suggest that you discuss with your dentist the type of graft to be used in your mouth. The medical words and their meanings are shown in this image. Although they appear to be quite different one from the other, all of them have been proven to be successful biologically. All types have very strict sterility and purity manufacturing regulations and are placed in graft sites using a very sterile technique. The grafting materials are supplied to the practitioner in sterile packaging, such as you're observing. The material in the syringe is a putty form of human bone that is easily placed in a bony defect, forming a scaffold or matrix for the patient's body to form new bone, as we've just described. As we've discussed, if grafting is not done, the bone shrinks, leaving a defect that usually negatively influences the aesthetic restoration of the site. Grafting provides more bone growth and better aesthetic result. This person had to have a tooth extracted. The site was grafted with human bone. The replaced tooth is part of a fixed bridge. As you can see, it appears to be normal in shape and color. And as you put a line across that, you will see that it's symmetrical with the remainder of the teeth on the other side. Another patient demonstrates how grafting can produce an aesthetically pleasing result. The tooth to be extracted. As you can see, it's grossly decayed. A graft placed in the socket, the before condition, and the final result after an implant and a crown have been placed. The graft helps significantly to allow this patient to have a sound restoration functionally, as well as a pleasant aesthetic result. That patient will not be able to recognize after even a few days that there's anything false there. Talk to your dentist. Your dentist can easily tell you if grafting is indicated in the situation you have in your own mouth. Often grafting is not necessary for an optimum result. However, when grafting is indicated, you should have it done to avoid the challenges you've seen in this presentation. Occasionally, although grafting would be a desirable solution to a clinical problem, for some reason, such as health, money, or a lack of a desire to have the graft, other alternatives must be considered. Such a situation is shown here. This mature patient did not desire to have a large graft to satisfy the clinical challenge. A porcelain fused to metal bridge was fabricated that had both tooth-colored and gum-colored ceramic on it. You must look closely to see the pink ceramic as it blends into the gum tissue. And as with many patients, this patient is not able to smile high enough to show the gums anyway. What have we really said? Your dentist can tell you the treatment alternatives. If he or she feels a graft should be done, you do it. The advantage is pretty clear. You'll grow more bone, and therefore either a fixed bridge or an implant can be placed in that area much better. The disadvantages of grafting? There aren't very many disadvantages, other than it costs a little bit of money, and your dentist will tell you how much. It's well worth that money. Are there risks? From time to time, a graft doesn't take, and there's still a void. You can regraft it. That would be very infrequent, however. What happens if nothing is done? Remember, what happens? The bone shrinks and you have a defect. You don't want that. Grafting should be accomplished for many clinical situations, especially in areas you show when you smile. However, it may not be necessary for some few other situations. Grafting is well worth the cost to satisfy many clinical situations that need more bone support or plumping of the bone for functional or aesthetic considerations. Ask your dentist about the alternatives for your situation.